So, today is one of the most beautiful verses. Mukta Bhimani Mukto Hibaddho Baddha Bhimanyapi Kevananti Hasatyam Yamati Hisagatir Bhavit. So, the simple translation first, and then we will go to the essence of it. Who considers himself free is free indeed. So he is talking of the freedom, and in that freedom we discover happiness. So he who considers himself, literal translation, so not a good translation, and he who considers himself bound remains bound. As one thinks, so one becomes. As one thinks, so one becomes is a popular saying in this world, and it is quite true. This is one way to translate. Now, let us go into a little deeper and understanding this verse. So what the master says, Mukta Abhimani Mukto, who am I? First let me know who am I. So here it shall be, who am I? And once I am aware who am I, then I can filter out all that who am I not. Am I Shelby? No, Shelby is a name. Am I David? David is a name. Am I male? No. Male is also a gender. Am I American? When we are searching the real self, no. American is also a label. So he is pointing out how knowledge of the real self removes and ends suffering. We are not able to remove our suffering because we don't want to leave our clinging attachment from the world outside. Not, K-N-O-T, not. This is the knot in the mind. This is the leash in the mind. This is the tether in the mind. Between the matter and the consciousness. I gave just, you know, I was giving an example. Candy having different color, shape, size. It is the external nature, but the sweetness, if you remove the sweetness, candy has no meaning. So what is essential gives meaning. Gives an essence. So who am I really gives this essence to the body, the mind, the intellect, my profession. Can you imagine and think of it? If consciousness is not there in the body, no meaning of this body. You may have a great name. You have a most beautiful name. You have a most beautiful body, but the consciousness is not there. Then this body has a no meaning. But we normally get attached. How dare you abused me? How dare you told me crazy? So when I say crazy, I'm referring to the body. I'm not referring to the consciousness. I am not referring to who the real I am. This is what he is referring to. Now, think of this. This is what happens in the intellect. The intellect becomes impure. What is that? Our real nature is pure consciousness. It is of the permanent happiness. What I'm going to say next. You see that my body is changing But something in me wants to hold the body. It says, no, do not change. What is this? This is what the ego sense is. But the matter has to change. Body is made up of matter. The house has to change. Do you see that? My eyes have to change. I'm now 61 years old, so I'm wearing glasses. But the mind says, no, do not change. Which mind? It has an ego sense. So that is what I was talking. The shape and the stuff of a candy is superimposed on the sweetness. Similarly, my mind, because of ignorance, not knowing the reality, superimposed the matter on my real nature. Then I claim this is me. And then I get into stress and suffering. I superimpose on myself that I am a husband. Honey, why don't you listen to me? Because I am a husband. Superimposition. See, that we do at every moment in our life. And that is how the intellect becomes impure. And this intellect creates an ego sense. And we are gone. Then we suffer. Are you getting it? How to get rid of this? How to get rid of this superimposition? That is what the master says. Mukta abhimani muktoho hi baddho baddhabhi manyapi. Your intellect is impure and claims, I am the husband, I am wife, I am teacher. Superimposition. Then you are bound to suffer. You will continue to suffer until you know your real nature. Body is changing, and I want this body should remain constant. My eyes are changing. I say, no, you do should not change. My phone is changing. I said, you should not change. I superimpose. So we need to think and reflect. We have to make our mind pure. Means the intellect should penetrate deeply to see the sweetness of a candy is independent of the stuff that is superimposed on it. Now apply this in life. My real nature is pure consciousness. Over it, I superimpose my religion, my cult, my dogma, my citizenship, my name, my form, my color, different labels. That is the problem. Now ask yourself, can you ever superimpose anything in the space? The space remains independent. You build a skyscraper and demolish it. Space remains the same. Are you getting it? I'm taking you a little deeper. Space remains the same. No change in the space. In that air, that nothing can be imposed, but we superimpose falsely a fragrance. Oh, we should have some aroma before doing meditation. Air remains free. Do you see? Air is totally untouched, but I superimpose. Similarly, can I put my real self in a bottle? Can I put consciousness in a bottle? No. Can I put this consciousness attached to the body? Answer is no. But then why I am attached? Because of the ego sense. I superimposed and I became one ego sense and then I claim I am suffering. Are you really suffering? That is what we see. Now think of that. Can I limit happiness? Can I measure quantity of happiness? So it happens because of the knot. It happens because of the leash. Most beautiful, very penetrating wisdom. Let us understand it. Knowledge. What is this knowledge? Where is this knowledge? From where the ego sense enters in our life. We are going there. Because the verse says, those who have an ego sense that they are bound, they will continue to remain bound and they will suffer from anxiety, from depression, from lot of other challenges. So let us classify the knowledge. One is the knowledge of the real self and one is the knowledge of others. I know you. Clear? First, the intellect says, I know you. Second, I like you. Clear? And then, I am your friend and you are my friend. This is one type of knowledge. Right? Clear? So because I know you, I like you, so I am your friend, can I be friend to myself? Do I like myself? Another type of knowledge. It happens in the field of awareness. It happens when the intellect is pure, there is no ego sense. Can you be friend to yourself? Do you say, I like me, I like myself, and I dislike myself? Are you getting it? So I know myself free from the liking and disliking. I know you based on my liking and disliking. So where comes the ego sense? Ego sense, first I know you. You are other than me. Then the ego sense, I like you. Then third, the ego sense that you are my friend. Other type of the knowledge? Knowledge of myself. Should I create a liking first before I know myself? Are you getting it? Are you getting it? No. The way I am. The way this barredness is there still. It has nothing to do with the liking and my disliking. I know myself. Knowledge of others goes always with the liking and disliking. Can you be friend to a person whom you dislike? The person, the mind, intellect says this is good and this is bad. Then we choose. That is the knowledge of others. The knowledge of others comes with a sense of ego, I-ness. But I know myself. Not a question of liking and disliking. Are you getting it? So the master says, the way you think, what you think, you become. So here the thinking is nothing exactly as a thought process, but it is an awareness. In the field of awareness, you come into my mind. Jerry, David, come into my mind. That mind gives a label that I like both of them. Then I know, then you are my friend. Can I be friend to myself? In the same way? No. I am simply aware. That awareness is nothing but a state of meditation. So knowledge of the real self comes from the intellect, which has become Manisha. What is Manisha? It is pure, simple intellect with a conviction. Do you have a conviction that I am here now listening? Do you have a conviction that I am alive? You're alive. That's why you're listening. That's why you're listening. But now see the knowledge of others. The person is lying on the bed, not moving. The guy did not move for 2 to 3 hours. What is whatever mind says? Oh, I don't know whether the person is alive or not. And still I know I'm alive. Mukta abhimani mukto hi baddho badhyabhi manyapi. Let us go a little deeper for the sake of understanding. Our desire, clinging, bondage lives in the sense organ, in the mind, and in the intellect. 3 levels. So he is saying that as long as the desire, the bondage, the clinging, the superimposition lives in the intellect, you create an ego sense that binds you, you live in bondage, and you suffer. So in the intellect, now that intellect has created an ego sense, now it lives in ignorance. In the morning, you start looking into the mirror. And the mind says, intellect says, I'm old. So the ego sense says, no, I have to maintain. I don't want you to change. I'm bound. I got limitedness. Ego sense comes. And that ego sense causes problem in our life. I told you before also, he was very close to one president and he had become my student and a friend in New Jersey. He has written a lot of books, at least 15 books on American democracy. I don't want to tell you the name. He died recently, 2 years ago. I was guiding him for at least 3 to 4 years. Why? What caused him anxiety? You'll be laughing at it. So he met me at the age of, I would say, 70. And first question he always asked me in almost every session. At the age of 40, I did not have any problem. I did not have any fear. Why I have fear? Why I have these problems? You see? The attachment with the body. I don't want to change my body. I don't want that my body should be changing. Become aware what is changing in this world. Constant changing. Constant changing. I change, I feel good. But you should not change because you are related to me. You understand that? Then what happens after a few years? I say, you don't love me the way you used to love me 10 years ago. What about you? Did you not change? So the ego sense does not see oneself. It perceives others based on liking and disliking. Creates an ego sense, and that ego sense lives our daily life. And as long as you live your daily life with that ego sense, you're gone. You have to suffer. So in that case, this great writer and thinker, New Jersey, he created an ego sense. Otherwise, in his circle, I attended a lot of parties with him. He was known as one of the best thinkers about democracy. But he never thought about himself. He did not reflect what he is doing. And only because of this thought, I would say he died. So our master says, Mukta Abhimani Muktohi. If you take your mind deeper within, purify the mind, lived in the purified intellect, from that intellect you perceive the reality, you become free. That is the highest meditation. Let us start our journey of meditation, and then we will share our experiences. Eyes are closed. So in this meditation journey, it is all about a knowledge practice, my friends. Eyes are closed. Why? In the beginning, we close our eyes symbolically that I cannot see myself, my real self, through the sense organs. So I am aware of all the sense organs if there is still an attachment, clinging. And then I look at the body. Simply look at the body, moving the mind from the top to the toes. Awareness of the body. What is this awareness of the body? You see, we start talking of aware, be mindful. So this awareness, sensation, feeling, knowledge of the body is the same thing. So you feel the body, good. You are aware of the body, good. But in that awareness, we experience the steadiness. Make sure, I will not ask you to do. I am only asking you to be aware. For that sake, I use awareness, knowledge, feeling, sensation, steadiness, stillness, etc., etc. That is the beauty of this teaching of this master. So now I say, look inside the heart. Looking, in fact, is not an action. Looking is again awareness. So you are aware of the heart within. Why do you become aware? Any object? Oh no, it is the emptiness, it is the space, it is the darkness. Very good. So just be aware of that space or darkness. In that space or darkness, become aware of a point. If I say, when your eyes are open, and I say, do you see the space in front? Yes. Can you become aware of a point in the space? I roughly say it is a diffusion process of the mind. You diffuse the mind. Means the mind that is attached to a lot of objects and people outside, the mind leaves all of them because you are aware of a point in the space. Beautiful. So in that space, we check, are we comfortable? So now understand again with that understanding. That is what we talked today. Intellect should be pure, clear, simple. And you move awareness through that intellect. Looking at the neck joint. Looking means you are aware, feeling, sensation of the neck joint. Then be there. And then mind suddenly moves at the subtler level. And you get an experience of sensation being comfortable and steadiness, my friend. Did you create steadiness? No. Did you create sensation? No. Did you create being comfortable? No. The moment you create anything, that is the practice, that is the method, that is the process. And when you want to know, who am I as it is, that becomes the higher meditation. Knowledge, for example, the knowledge of David will remain the knowledge of David. I cannot distort it. If I distort it, I have created an ego sense. This is the journey. Yes, you have understood. So looking at the shoulder joints. Look, feel, become aware. And then the mind goes deeper. You feel the sensation, being comfortable. And you experience the steadiness. You don't create steadiness, my friends. That is the point. Pure ego sense, impure ego sense. It's a point of awareness. Impure ego sense says, no, body is changing, I don't want that this should change at all. You see? So when I superimpose means, I'm living in ignorance. The body has to change. It's an eternal law. Entire body. Look at all the joints of the body. Looking, feeling, being aware. So you see that gradually you move. Looking at shoulder joints, hip joint, elbows, wrist, finger joints, knees, ankles, toes. Are you imposing anything? Please do not. Get the knowledge as it is. And in that field of awareness, you feel the sensation being comfortable. And steadiness. So based on this teaching of this verse, let us be carefree. Knowledge of others and knowledge of myself. Is thought you or other than you? We have to become aware all the thoughts that enters into the mind is not me. Pure ego sense. Impure ego sense, oh, thoughts are disturbing me because I like them, because I dislike them. That's why the thoughts are disturbing me. What do you mean? The mind may ask. Just be aware. I see the computer screen and I'm aware I'm not this. Simple. So I see the thoughts coming and going, entering and leaving, staying there. Nothing to do with me is being carefree. See that? It is here and now, in every step, the state of meditation is here and now. Now we will decolor the mind with an idea of superimposition. I just explained about candy, so the shape and the form and the color is superimposed on the sweetness and it becomes candy. Really? This type of the body with this height and shape and the name and the label and the color is superimposed on my real self, pure consciousness. That is being casual. The waves are superimposed on the water. What? Then who am I? Body is superimposed, then who am I? Master says, you are pure consciousness. Looking at the head and the neck, awareness, feeling, sensation, looking, all are synonyms. So looking at the head and the neck, being there, and when you are there, when I keep looking at my house, neighbor's house, I want to see the house was superimposed in one space. Similarly, when you look at the head and the neck, the space all around, outside, the space is inside. In that state of the mind, we experience sensation, relaxation, and stillness, which is natural. It is permeating, it is pervading like the space. And that is pure awareness. That is the real I. It is not scanning the body, looking at the right arm, and then going beyond the right arm, dropping the superimposition many ways. One is become aware of the space all around the right arm, then the space all around inside. Just be there in the field of awareness. You experience sensation, relaxation, and stillness. Did you create stillness? Did you create relaxation? Left arm, all around, inside and outside. What is the common element is the space. Let the intellect be there in the state by thinking now, by awareness. And you experience sensation, relaxation, and stillness. The entire middle portion of the body, from the shoulder to the waist, front and the back, ribcage in the belly and the spine in the back, common factor, the space outside and inside. You're not doing anything, you are aware. What is social distancing nowadays? The space in between both of us. But am I the body? No. So we drop that superimposition. Right leg. Keep looking at the right leg, then you become aware of the space all around, the container. But that container is nothing but the space inside and outside. It is one. Sensation, relaxation, and stillness. You know, by these processes, in the field of a knowledge, we bypass what is superimposed to see what is real as it is. Did I say you to think and imagine and dream? That is why it is also a higher meditation. The left leg. Sensation, relaxation, and stillness. And now we will play with our intellect in a mode of clarity, conviction, and doubt-free, we want to live into this field of awareness. Become aware of the room, the items present in the room. Who is looking? The mind. What it is looking? The mind is looking others, two types of knowledge. That is what we discussed and understood. We are clear. You will have no thought if there is no liking and disliking by the sense organs in the mind. But still it is the physical mind is looking at these objects in the room. Come closer. Let this mind become aware of the physical body. The mind is aware of the physical body. Now see from where the superimposition comes. The mind says body is alive. Can matter be alive? Can any matter be alive? What is the testimony of consciousness and what is the testimony of matter? Put this into your intellect in the field of awareness and you will get an answer. The matter as such does not know itself, one, and it cannot know others. My smartphone, your smartphone, does not know itself and it does not know others. I am conscious. I know others and I know myself. That will help you to find out. Yes, now I see this body is matter. Body appears alive, but still it consists of the matter. See that? Can I see that truth all the time? Then I will play with the body. The moment I don't see it, the body will play with me. You have a little pain and you start crying. Let us go a little deeper than the body. Deeper than the body, we encounter the breath. Keep looking at the breath. Just know what the breath is doing. First thing, the breath is changing constantly. How do we know? The breath is going in and coming out. Do not change the rate and the rhythm of the breath. Is breath me? No. When I'm not the body and the breath is moving into the body, you see the shape of the candy? The body. Coloring? Breath is going in and out. Feeling the sensation of the breath. Who watches this breath? It is the subtle mind. When the mind becomes dense, it has strong liking and disliking. That is how I'm explaining today. When this mind or intellect becomes subtle, it starts filtering out. Is sweetness in a candy is because of the color? See that? I'm comparing that. The intellect is living in that field of awareness. So the subtle mind is looking at the breath. Is existence because of the breath? So subtle mind is looking at the breath. The impure ego sense will come and say, what the hell you are talking about? I exist even if I am blind. I exist even if I am deaf. But then how do I say I am blind? As if I am the eyes. See that superimposition clearly. Simply you have to see it. You have to look into it. Similarly, when I say I am the breath, it is the subtle mind. Let us go a little deeper. Deeper than the breath, deeper than the movement of the breath, are the movement of thoughts, feelings, sensation, experiences taking place in the mind. It is the subtler mind that is looking. Just for the sake of understanding, clarity, doubt-free understanding, that's why I say it's a purely gross or physical mind, then the mind with the body, then the mind with the breath. I am still knowing others. I believe you are clear. I appreciate. When I'm talking, I move into that field of awareness. That gives me the joy. Subtler mind is looking at the movement of these. Where there is a movement, that cannot be me. Finished. Thoughts are moving? Yes. Coming and going? Yes. Why it is coming and going? Because of likes and dislikes. What happens? Creates an ego sense. Superimposition. Then the intellect says, I claim this is me. My master used to say that this is foolishness. What is being? Foolishness. I know what it is and still I claim what it is not. So I already have a freedom from all these thoughts because that is the knowledge of others. Look at it. Look the beauty of this teaching. Okay, can the mind go deeper than these thoughts, feelings, sensation, experiences? The mind cannot transcend its own experiences, its own concept, its own thought process and experiences. Let me ask you differently and become aware. Can the mind see what is behind itself? That is the limit of the mind. What is the limit? All the experiences takes place in the mind when the object is in front of the mind. So when I say go deeper, what is left to see, to become aware as an object? Nothing. It is pure consciousness. It is nothing but the empty space. Who is looking at the empty space? I. Who is this I? I am aware. Awareness is looking at awareness. I'm using the word deliberately. Intentionally, awareness is looking at the awareness. Who am I? If there is no consciousness, there is no I. So I am is awareness now. We have already understood that this body, the breath, the mind, the thoughts, feeling, all the experiences are superimposition. I am awareness looking at awareness. I am in meditation. That is what many people have, many masters have given different phrases, choiceless awareness. To know myself, I don't need to like and dislike, to create an ego sense, to claim this is me and I am. I cannot be friend with me to know myself. In that field of awareness, which is like a fire that drops all the attachment. We did nothing. We are still doing nothing. We are in the state of doing nothing. When we do not something, means we want to create something. When we want to know something, it is object-oriented. What is the object of our knowing today? My real nature. So I discover this me and mine is pure consciousness. We are already doing nothing. Live into that state. You know, living into that state is also something that creates an ego sense. A state of doing nothing. Do I need to become aware of the infinite space? No. That is the beauty of this journey of the Eastern wisdom. That self is a witness, all-pervading, perfect, one, free, actionless, unattached, desireless, and quiet. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Bring your awareness on the right hand. Your awareness on the left hand. Lift your Buddha palms, place it on your eyes, remain in that state. Bring your hands down, and we will discuss and share our experiences now. How are you, Sam? Unmute. I see movement of your lips. Yes.
We're good now?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Still figuring this out. It was very peaceful. There were definitely, you know, every time I had a thought, I felt like I was just kind of like swatting it away like a fly. Actually, yesterday, I woke up and I said, I'm going to have a no-thought day. And anytime anything flew in, I just like swatted it away. And I had the best day ever yesterday.
It's a good approach.
Because it was like, I don't know, it was like, oh, maybe you should, I don't know, work out today. And then I swatted it away. I worked out anyway, but I just didn't let it. I was arguing with it. It was amazing. And I was doing a little bit of that now, too.
This is what I say, Sam. You play with the mind or the mind plays with you. Perfect example that if you play with the mind, you are free. If the mind plays with you, that creates an ego sense. I didn't do this. I have to do this. Then from these two thoughts, it multiplies. You have 10 thoughts. From 10 thoughts, you have 100 thoughts. We don't give a break.
Yeah.
And they all belong to ego sense. I appreciate this is the way to understand and live our life. How are you, David and Jerry?
It was a very meditation for me. I love the words you were speaking through the whole process, and I just again heard the words, had very few thoughts, and didn't quite swat the thoughts away like Sam was describing, but I really dismissed them pretty quickly when they did come along. And so for that, I was able to get really, really deep. In fact, my arms were asleep in the pool with the focus on our right hand. So it was kind of interesting. Thank you.
Beautiful. You know, you see that when you are doing the practice, especially Saturdays, you will have a variety of experiences. There will be a sudden upsurge of energy, tingling, numbness. Any limb may sleep. We have to recognize, accept it, and move deeper. And that is the way it should be done. Wonderful. How are you, Jerry?
I'm doing well. I also had the thoughts, but I was just carefree with them. I just let them be, and they didn't distract me, but they were going by. And the message I really like, because everything's always changing and get attached to stuff, and if we just carefree and graceful and let things change and know that we're not, our essence isn't changing, and that's just something to,
yes,
sometimes, like, you know, I don't like the way things are changing sometimes as well. Right, so it is just something to be aware of and have that same, like Sam's saying, just bat that away, because that's just the way it's going, right?
That's the way it's going, yeah. And I'm separate from what is changing. I'm not the body. So first point that you got it right. First point that this body is constantly changing. This is one way to look at it. But this, I am not the body. Now, ego sense says, I am the body. Why the hell body you are changing? I should remain as young, as beautiful, or as handsome? Huh? As Sam is? Not possible. You know, not possible. Not possible. So not possible. So that, I have to put this, the truth into my head. And once that is there and you live your life, Terry, how are you?
I'm fine. I was just aware of everything, the darkness, the space, the lights, the body, my thoughts, what you were saying, all the same awareness of all of them.
Yeah.
And I was following what you were saying, except I think I got lost like two times.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I came back into awareness and went, I don't understand that part. And then I just kept going and...
You didn't move.
No, I didn't move. And I decided, or my left arm went numb, and I decided not to do anything about it. And my cell phone buzzed, and that distracted me. And I decided, okay, well, that's too bad. That's unfortunate, but didn't do anything about it.
So whenever your sickness challenges your body, remind your mind that I am pure consciousness that does not move. Separate yourself and you will see a tremendous difference. I don't want to say it, but you know what will happen. Even the problem of Parkinson is left behind, is left separate from you. That is the key. So I don't say only except you and those who come closer to understanding this Eastern wisdom, then only I say, yes, I can help you and support you. But otherwise, because people start thinking objectively, what you do, what meditation can help me. But now you are doing it. In some days, their body doesn't move at all. It means it is 100% possible. If I live into that field of awareness 24/7, where is your problem? How are you, Stephen?
I'm good. I find it very interesting. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Especially on Saturdays, because there's a lot of similarities with everybody's experiences on Saturday. And everything of what Sam described, what David and Jerry described, and what Terry described, I had every one of those experiences during this meditation, even to the point when Terry talks about her left hand, it was my left knee.
Yes.
So, and I haven't felt that before. So it was just very interesting.
Beautiful. No, it will happen sometime. We will understand later that why my particular limb gets numb and why not the whole body. So as we progress, we will understand, oh, it is because of this. It is because of this. It is this truth. How are you, another young friend, Shelby?
I'm doing well. I felt very aware of my experience. I was having thoughts, and then the timing of you mentioning the like and the don't like, and like how we place that, how our mind places that on things. I just then began to have awareness about my like and don't like of the thoughts, and so then I was able to remove that and kind of continue forward.
You see that? You see, my friends, that everyone's intellect picks up different ideas. And that is why as we continue the journey, you know, she picked up likes, dislikes, ego sense causes the problem, leave it. What is left? Pure awareness. So now, can I live my life beyond likes and dislikes? It does not mean I should not express it. Let me express this in the world, but internally I know what is happening. Then I remain free. How are you, Ashok? Happy Diwali.
Happy Diwali. Aapko bhi sabhi ko. Happy Diwali. And I'm doing good, better. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Very good. Very good. So please, I'm going to send the audio file. You need to do the listen to it. You simply listen to it and couple of thoughts are there. The moment your mind and ego sense claims I'm into anxiety, remember the principle. Become aware. Ego sense superimposed. Likes and dislikes. Oh, this is not me. Just say to yourself, this is not me, and become aware and see what happens. I can promise that you'll have a smile on your face. Oh, I'll with you, anxiety. You cannot touch me. I know. That is the way these masters were living their life. Do everything. You know, I mean to say, do everything what is right. Don't take it in a different way. So what is right has to be understood by the intellect. So my life and living has to be done with that manisha, with that field of awareness. Then I am free here and now. I am free all the time. And the happiness is always there with me. Wonderful. I am very happy you all are getting some essence of the teachings of these masters. You know, I'm not teaching anything. I'm simply a pointer. You get it, very good. You then don't get it, very good. It's your mind. We shouldn't force. Why should I say that I'm teaching, you should get it? This is also an ego sense. See that? No. Shall we? That is my way of teaching. That is your should be your way of guiding and counseling others. Then where comes the question of empathy and sympathy? If my client is crying, why should I cry? But sometimes I play with myself, you know, I also start crying, but internally not, to change the direction of those people. You all are living in meditative state. That is all for today. Thank you.
Thank you.